So this video is all about a hormone that's in your brain right now, affecting your current mood, your memory, and the quality of the sleep you'll get tonight when you go to bed. Serotonin. In this video, I talk about what is serotonin, how the brain uses serotonin, where does it affect, how it's made and where it's released, what symptoms does too high or low serotonin cause, how stress can deplete serotonin, and how to boost serotonin naturally. Serotonin is a pretty complex neurotransmitter and it's also produced in the gut. So in this video, I try to make serotonin simple, and also this is mainly focused on the brain and the nervous system. So let's start. What is serotonin? Serotonin, also known as 5-HT, is a neurotransmitter and a neuromodulator and is mainly known for its importance for happiness and mood. But serotonin has many other roles besides happiness, and I talk about this in a bit. Serotonin works in a specific brain network called the serotonergic system. It originates from the brainstem from an area called raphe nuclei, where serotonin is produced. From here, there are serotonergic pathways to pretty much all over the brain. In this network, serotonin stimulates serotonin receptors. Currently, we know that there are 7 types of serotonin receptors, 1 to 7, but these also have their own subtypes, for example 5-HT1A and B and so on, making altogether 14 different types of serotonin receptors. I won't go into details, it's just good to acknowledge that they have different effects on your behavior and mood and sensations, and also that some excite nerve cells and others inhibit them. So brain serotonin is produced from the amino acid tryptophan. This is found in foods like protein, oat, and bananas. The amino acid tryptophan that you eat can enter into 2 pathways, either the serotonergic pathway, so for the serotonin production, or the kynurenine pathway, which produces NAD. In this serotonin pathway, tryptophan travels to your brain via the blood-brain barrier. Enzymes convert first into 5-HTP and then into serotonin. Now, there are a couple of factors that affect the efficacy of this process, and I talk about them more in detail in the section how to increase serotonin naturally. So after this serotonin is synthesized, it's stored into these brain cell vesicles, and when serotonergic brain cells are stimulated, it's released. Many things can lead to the release of serotonin, like exercise, positive experiences, eating carbohydrates, having some sunlight, and so on. And this is an interesting part. After the serotonin is released in the brain, it's also reuptaken to the presynaptic neuron, so to the nerve cell that actually released it, through these transporters that are called serotonin reuptake transporters. So what does serotonin actually do? What's the role in our everyday behavior? So now, serotonin has a lot of different effects in our everyday behavior and in our cognition and mood, but I talk about 7 of them that are very well studied and affects to our life quite significantly. Firstly, serotonin is important for mood and mental states. It facilitates feelings of positivity, especially these kind of calm types of positive emotions, like the feeling of contentment and general well-being. Serotonin appears to have mainly inhibitory and calming effects on the higher brain regions, unlike, for example, dopamine or noradrenaline, which are stimulating. Serotonin is also linked to some positive social emotions like agreeableness, empathy, and harm aversion. And serotonin drop is actually linked to enhanced memory for negative facial expressions and negative information. And I talk about some other aspects of low serotonin later in this video. Next one is sleep. Serotonin is very important for the regulation of sleep, although it's not simply just making you sleepier. Actually, during the day, serotonin is linked to increased wakefulness. But this period of wakefulness during the day seems to be very important to the sleep onset in the evening. And also sleep quality, especially the slow wave sleep, which is also called deep sleep. Another aspect of sleep is that serotonin is converted into melatonin in the brain, which is the sleep onset hormone. And although its release is mainly linked to ambient darkness, it's also strongly connected to brain serotonin expression. This conversion from serotonin to melatonin is facilitated by some vitamins, including zinc and magnesium, B vitamins, and folate. The next role of serotonin is memory. So serotonin modulates neurotransmitters and neurotransmitter systems involved in memory processes. And there are a lot of serotonin receptors in the brain area called hippocampus, which is heavily involved in memory, especially consolidation of the memory and forming long-term memories. The next role of serotonin is controlling or suppressing appetite. So sometimes you may have noticed a feeling of hunger and that even a little carbohydrate containing food like a banana suppresses that hunger. So it's not necessarily linked to the calories in the banana because it's a pretty low calorie thing. It might be related of the increases in the serotonin in your brain.
That's a great story. Can I eat it?
The next role is pain perception. Serotonin is one of the most known pain-suppressing neurotransmitter. In studies where they manipulate people's serotonin levels to be low, also their pain sensitivity increases. Serotonin also helps control some basic bodily functions like body temperature and breathing. The final role of serotonin is in addiction. And this might be surprising for some because usually the neurotransmitter that's linked to addiction is dopamine. However, many addictive substances like opioids and alcohol and things like that increases serotonin. And during withdrawal, the drop in serotonin can cause anxiety and nervousness and even sadness. And this may make the person to seek behaviors that increase this serotonin again, like the substance that one is trying to avoid. So these were some of the very important functions of your brain serotonin. And now let's look at some of the things that may follow if you have too low or too high serotonin levels. Low serotonin is usually linked to mood and sleep issues. Disrupted serotonin function is one of the most known risk factors for depression. But besides this, lowered serotonin can cause a variety of other symptoms like bipolar disorder, sadness, anxiety and nervousness, irritability and aggression.
Hey, Tribbiani, give me that coffee now!
Stress sensitivity, changes in libido, too much REM sleep and little deep sleep, problems in falling asleep and maintaining the proper circadian rhythm, digestive problems, and things like OCD or PTSD and panic. So it's definitely good to support your serotonin balance with healthy lifestyle. But too high serotonin is not good either. So although high normal levels of serotonin have positive effect on mood, abnormally high levels can lead to a syndrome called serotonin syndrome. And this can be caused because of basically multiple things like too much serotonergic drugs, antidepressants, or serotonergic psychedelics, inhibition of serotonin uptake, slower serotonin degradation, increased serotonin synthesis, increased serotonin release, and activation of serotonergic receptors. So the symptoms of serotonin syndrome include things like shivering, sweating, confusion, restlessness, muscle twitches, fever, seizures, and even fainting. So serotonin syndrome can be dangerous, although it's very, very rare. So I guess the take home here is that if you are currently having, for example, a serotonergic medication, then you need to be very careful with other medications that increase your serotonin or some serotonergic supplements and things like that. And you always need to consult your doctor before trying different medications. So if you have low serotonin levels, how to boost serotonin naturally? You can try to increase serotonin without any medications. There are some very efficient natural ways to increase it. So I'm going to go through 6 ways to do this. Firstly, eat high tryptophan foods which has low BCAA content. So to make serotonin, you need serotonin precursors, which means that you need to get tryptophan from your diet. And although tryptophan is found in many protein-rich foods like turkey and meat and dairy, there is a little twist here. These foods also contain other large neutral amino acids that compete of the access to the brain with tryptophan. So unfortunately, tryptophan is usually the last one to get into the brain. But there is a way around it. So if you eat carbs, that raises your insulin. That shuffles the other amino acids into muscles and organs, and more tryptophan stays in the bloodstream and can now easily access to the brain. There is also some foods that contain both tryptophan and carbs, for example, banana and oats, kiwi, plums, dates, and tomatoes. There was also a systematic review that concluded that L-tryptophan supplement between 0.14 and 3 grams daily may improve mood, and other studies link this to better sleep onset as well, so which would imply that it might increase the serotonin, which makes sense because tryptophan is the precursor, so maybe worth trying. However, if you are on medication that affects serotonin, then talk to your healthcare provider before trying it. So then we have exercise. Several studies actually suggest that exercise can increase serotonergic activity in the brain. This might be because of stimulation of the serotonergic brain cells, and also because of this improved tryptophan transport to the brain. So exercise activates the protein clearance from the bloodstream to the muscles. This clearance of the BCAAs would again facilitate tryptophan transport to the brain, and this would increase serotonin synthesis in the brain. So forward. In the brain conversion from the tryptophan to serotonin, the slowest step is the hydroxylation of tryptophan. So this process can be inhibited with high amounts of dopamine. Therefore, it's important that these two neurotransmitters are in balance. And if you want to learn more about dopamine and how to manage its levels, check out my video on that topic. The fifth way is managing stress and inflammation. As I mentioned in the beginning, there are two pathways that uses tryptophan: serotonin synthesis pathway and kynurenine pathway. So the kynurenine pathway is important in regulating inflammation, generating energy, and improving immunity, and it's upregulated when you have inflammation or stress in your body. So if tryptophan is moved more towards this pathway because of inflammation or stress, then you may have less tryptophan available for the serotonin pathway.
I feel thin.
So learning basic stress management and managing inflammation seems to be pretty important. There is also some links of gut microbiome balance and inflammation to the brain tryptophan. So making sure that you support your gut microbiota seems to also be important for tryptophan. The next one is sunlight and bright light. So both sunlight and bright light increase serotonin in the brain. Studies show, for example, that brain serotonin production is higher during the bright summer season compared to the dark winter season. Light is also used as help with seasonal depression. And bright light has also shown to protect from mood-lowering effects caused by tryptophan depletion. Working indoors is actually associated with suboptimal light exposure, so the best thing you can do to support your serotonin with light is to take daily walk outside or open the window regularly during sunlight hours. One thing you can do is go out the first thing in the morning to get some sunlight exposure. This both supports your serotonin and your evening melatonin production. It's shown to be very effective in regulating circadian rhythm. The final way to increase serotonin naturally is positive thinking. So the link between serotonin and mood could be actually a two-way road. And what I mean by this is that not only the increase in serotonin leads to positive mood, but positive mood can also increase serotonin synthesis and release. So for example, when people are asked to recall a positive life event, the serotonin synthesis increases compared to recalling a sad or neutral emotional event. So using your imagination, like imagining and visualizing positive things, doing something like loving kindness meditation, or writing a journal where you list three good things that happened during the day, may increase your serotonin.
It is a beautiful sunny day as we walk through the meadow. That is very spiritual and relaxing, and there are flowers.
So as a summary, serotonin is a neurotransmitter that has positive effects on your mood, your calmness, your memory, your sleep, temperature, breathing, appetite, and pretty much all aspects of health. If you have deficiencies in serotonin, you may experience lowered mood or sadness or depression, and you can support your serotonin balance and serotonin levels by certain lifestyle practices like tryptophan, sunlight, and exercise. So that's it for this video. If you like this video, subscribe to the channel and press the bell button to receive notification when a new video is out, and press the thumb for a like. And I'd of course love to hear from you, so comment below your thoughts or if you have any questions so I can address these in the future videos and in the comments section. And have a great day. See you soon.